First of all, why is it so dark?
I don't, I look at...
Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're gonna be doing a little trip down memory lane. Although it's a little cringy, I think it's important to talk about. Where you started versus where you want to go. So I know there's a lot of hold up when people want to start businesses or logos or branding or anything. We always tend to get caught up in making it perfect. So the point of today's video is to just launch, work it out as you go and evolve, and there's nothing wrong with that. So we're gonna poke fun at some earlier Lash Affair today, and feel free and don't try to lie. Don't try to be like, oh, it looks cute, because I'm right here. I can see you and I have eyes. So, my eyes are already welling up, because I know it's going to be good. So we had to swap out the computer because apparently my computer couldn't handle the time travel. So we have the first post pulled up. So November 2013, we say that Lash Affair launched in 2014. So as you can see, I was already percolating. This is a screenshot of a strip lash for sure. And I don't know really what I was thinking. I have no other feedback.
Some spider vibes?
I have no other feedback. And along with the second one, which I think, yep, same day. I was like, let's go for two. Oh, this third one. This is actually, my friend Tori, I did those lashes. It's 2013.
Yep. 2013 brows.
I thought I was killing it with these lashes. I was like, we gotta put those up immediately. We didn't know what we were doing back then. This is really, I think, the strong message. No caption. Now, this is also another photo that I took. It was one of my first, like, kind of first photo shoots. It wasn't for Lash Affair. It was for Beauty Couture, which is my little business.
Yes.
This is a professional photo. These are classic lashes. I still think these are great. What's that gap?
I don't know what the, yeah.
What's the gap? Mm-hmm. I could have taken a little mascara one, but I was like, no, looks like, good. Make sure you shoot it. I was probably really concerned with the people action, which I respect that because it's lined up, but just run a brush through there.
Just run a brush.
It's the least you can do. I just want to talk about the font that was used. It's like the most basic font. I even hate saying that. But I didn't know how to do anything. Like, I didn't know how to take a photograph and put text on it.
Nobody did.
Like,
yet.
There wasn't Canva,
this is what we're all doing,
which
inside.
Is a pro tip, right? I don't even know how pro that is because it seems like a pretty common platform that people go to create graphics. But if you're looking for an easy place to make graphics for stories, templates, whatever, PowerPoint presentations, like you name it, they have it in there. So this was like game changing for me when I discovered how to use Canva. So I think I had asked my friend's boyfriend at the time to do graphic design, like to pop that text over, and I paid somebody to do that.
It's a great photo.
Is it though?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, just not maybe for this.
Oh, www.lashaffair.com. I was like, make sure everybody knows. So this, oh my God, right here. This mirror, mirror on the wall, who does the fiercest volume lashes of them all? Upload your best volume lashes and tag Lash Affair by GP. Now, this is kind of funny because we've been doing the Lash Affair of the Month contest pretty much
always.
Since then, yeah. I think we've missed like a month or two here and there, but like that's pretty legit. Like we've been doing it, giving people shout outs. You know, it's cute to recognize our community, but you know, it's not cute.
I think we need to bring it back.
That
I think
graphic.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who does the fiercest volume lashes? I think we did it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we need to bring that
back. Well, I remember like fierce, like that's when like that term was like popular. Like everyone's like, you're fierce. So where did that come from? I can't remember, but.
More descriptive.
More descriptive than blurry?
Ah! Blurry! I was gonna say blurry! Like, I was like, white boxes, that was the only requirement. We're just like, yep, stop there, that's good.
That's good.
Like, we care. Why do you act like you don't? Well, we always cared. And like, the most, too. Like, hungry. Like, gotta get it, you know? The earlier years are really, it's, like I said, humbling because
totally.
I just look and I'm like, this looks like... was like, here's a
computer. We're still using Instagram filters, like that one for sure.
Yes,
that's,
yeah.
Those are Instagram
but
filters.
But that's the thing, like, where was Visco
was
and all of those things was a year without summer is like a life without lashes. That was one of the first photo shoots we did for Lash Affair.
She's adorable.
And that's my friend Natalie, and I love her. We just reconnected. She's gorgeous. I love her. She's such a beautiful person. Oh my God, if you zoom in on those trays.
Do they have those little flower decals?
No, it wasn't a flower decal. It was our first logo. Thanks. This logo right here is the side profile with the woman that had the lashes.
Oh, yes, yes.
That's right. Let's talk about how good I felt about that. I was working with...
It was like one swipe. Too.
A designer we hired, this lady from California, and I was like in love with her work. And she was so sweet. We look back and I'm like... Oh my God.
Ew! To-do list, got the mallet. Ew, I can't even. It's like yellow and yellow pink. Order.
This was truly our first photo shoot. Professional one with she was Miss Massachusetts or something at the time. She was like one of those beauty queen girls. I don't know what you call pageant girl.
Yeah,
I don't know what I'm talking about. I love the photo where she covered the one eye. That's really cute. Also did those lashes. They were just classic. But what was I trying to show people on set? That's the website.
I really had to like tilt my head to read what that said.
Who puts a website like that? Sure. Number one. Is number two, Trump? Why is the L and the A
different.
Come on. Why are you doing it?
It was cool.
Why are you killing me past me? I've been keeping it real with the French Bulldogs. That was a post.
Always.
August 26, 2014, little doggy with lashes. I'm gonna talk about this for a second because I wanna use this as an opportunity to remind people to be nice. I remember how I felt this day looking at this photo. So it was, those are blue lashes.
Oh, are they?
Yeah, a little bit.
Totally.
Hillary had done them. We were in Vegas and I posted them and they're a little long for me. Like I wouldn't wear them.
Totally.
Like that. Yeah. Now, I remember, and I'm not gonna go down the comments and I'm not gonna troll troll myself. I'm not gonna bring it back. But I remember the overwhelming amount of comments that were talking shit about my brows. This is before I had microblading or anything, and they were like, oh, the brows. I was like, that's what you chose
that's
to comment
what you're looking
on.
At.
And I remember just like hurting my feelings and being like, wow,
lashes.
Like,
oh my
people
God.
Are crazy. I probably deleted them. I was so butthurt. But I mean, it's not doing it for me now, just looking at it. But
that was 2014, wasn't it?
Be nice. And if you feel like somebody needs an enhancement, maybe just DM them. Maybe just don't
put them on blast.
In the comments section. Or not, we will. We'll work for
we'll
lash extensions. Sorry,
lash
you can get that out of my wah wah. We'll work for lash extensions. Fun fact, that is actually a photo of me. That went viral and I remember being upset for the first time of like not tagging the photo. Like it didn't say Lash Affair anywhere.
Oh,
like
on the actual photo
itself. And I remember I was like, God, I missed the opportunity. Like that was my moment.
Yep.
To go viral. And
yep.
I just flubarted. So needless to say, that is moi. I was in the driveway, held up the sign, fighting off bees. I was behind them. I was like, take the fucking picture. There's like bees looming. So it's all fun and games until you get stuck.
Stung by a bee.
But happy Halloween post, the stock image. I feel like for me, I just can't handle stock imagery of like lash stuff. Like I get it if it's like here's my teacup or whatever, but like if you're,
they're like
that's fine, you little filler.
Extra,
if you want to do
extra.
A post and need a blog photo,
totally.
Or a desk, like whatever. I'm just keeping the desk and
mega,
like
mega
the desk.
Bigger, probably.
But don't use stock images on lashes. That's just my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. Okay, let's pull this bitch up. So this is November 10th, 2014. So really not that long. So April, May, June, July, November, here we are. I'm like, we gotta rebrand.
So me.
Jenelle's rebrand number one.
Yeah.
Yep. Rebrand number one happened November the 10th. So we were like, I can't deal with the red. This is what it was. I was like, I can't deal with this color. We're gonna go to black and white. We'll sprinkle in gold.
Cool. Okay.
So that, yeah, it lasted about us. I don't know,
yeah.
How many months is that? Not a long time, maybe 6 months. And I was like, we gotta
get
the color out of my life. Oh, let's call this one out. This is sweet. I was really into champagne for like a while. And we don't really drink it nearly because I'm like old and it gives me like nausea and I can't.
Bloating.
But yes, also bloating. But yeah, times have changed. Official. We were officially trademarked.
Oh, fun!
December 12th, 2014, so that we can start using that Circle R, which is another pro tip.
Mm-hmm.
If you do have a business, I recommend getting your IP in order. So intellectual property is really important to secure your name. ideas, product stuff, whatever, that's gonna be copied, whatever, but make sure you lock down your name. So no, let's do two more because this is amazing. All right. So we've scrolled up. We're now in 2015. It's been a year.
Is it a real?
No. So right. No.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, let's. What do you think that is?
It looks like a strip lash that you put on a necklace and have people wear them.
She says that like it's not a hot item that should be in Vogue magazine. These are artisanal necklaces.
Oh.
Handcrafted from the finest of strip lash. So I was like, we have to give something to our students because they can't buy love our students.
Yeah.
Right? Still do. Love them. We just now give them different things.
Yeah.
So I was hand making necklaces, like every part of that's by scratch. Like
totally.
I was gluing a strip lash to a piece of metal. And that, if you look even closer, there's a little Eiffel Tower charm.
Because
we used to have Eiffel Tower in our brain because
yeah.
Paris. But that is
the worst photograph. Yeah.
The flash is clearly on. What the fuck? Now, last one before we'll wrap it up. This photo here is like, first of all, why is it so dark?
I know, I can barely see it.
Hi, first of all.
People in there?
That's a filter that I selected.
Oh, yeah. On purpose.
On purpose. But like, why? What are you doing?
Do you want the black
Pass
naturally.
Me. Why? So first of all, that photo was taken from the inside of a cave. And I was like, make sure that gets posted today. And that's
that.
It. So, oh my God, early Zoe.
No.
It is funny. It's just happy to have, you know, learned a lot over the years and
completely.
Built relationships with professional photographers. And, you know, I've actually learned quite a few things myself and I can buzz around Canva like nobody's business.
Oh yeah, you can.
Yeah. If you're really drunk or really bored, take a scroll down memory lane and scroll to the beginning of Lash Affair. And it's kind of, it's funny. So,
and be kind to your past self.
What show is that when they do like a wrap up the end and they're like, be kind? It's like Oprah and Ellen, maybe.
Yeah. What is it, Mr. Rogers?
Ooh, all these are good choices. Be kind and stretch.